dope. You're big, damn. What is up, guys? Game Changers here once again with another installation of Mass Effect 4 Andromeda. If this is your guys' first time checking out the channel, then please, bottom right-hand corner, get that little subscription button to click so you guys can stay up to date with what's going on with the channel. And social media links are in the description below. And with that, let's play Mass Effect Andromeda. Is this like the loading? Okay, no.
Ryder, good to see you on your feet. We're at the Nexus. It's the forward hub for the entire Andromeda Initiative. The Asari, Solarian, and Turian arcs should be there too.
Let's hope they've had better luck.
Starting our approach now.
It's almost as big as the Citadel back home.
Nexus Control, this is Archive 3 requesting docking clearance. Captain, I'm only getting their automated approach channel. Not a live person.
Well, like it or not, we're here. Take us in.
Construction should have been finished by now.
Could be worse. How? Habitat 7's a bust. We might have started a war with the first aliens we met, and our Pathfinder's dead. This better be rock bottom.
Green across the board. Docking initiated.
Nah, man, everybody here's dead, dude. The construction's not finished. Yeah, dude, everybody here's dead.
All right. I got us here. Good luck, Pathfinder.
Fucked. We're all fucked. Okay.
Captain just called me Pathfinder. This is really happening.
Just take a deep breath.
I still can't believe Dad's dead. This should have been his moment.
But now it's yours. You just need to decide what you're gonna do with it.
Where do I?
It's kind of weird. Like whenever you run, like your guy like kind of waves a little bit all over the place.
It'll be nice to see some friendly faces this time.
The Nexus runs a support crew. Just enough to finish building the station and provide safe harbor for the Arcs.
Means we can start waking our people up.
They built a bar, right? Gotta have champagne for the welcome party.
You're expecting one?
After what we've been through, I could use a buzz.
We all could.
Yeah. Rough ride so far.
We'll bounce back. Real food and a shower are just ahead.
Ew, does that mean he hasn't bathed in 600 years?
Here we are.
I don't see any champagne.
Where is everybody?
Nah, dude, everybody's dead.
Well, this can't be right.
It's like everything's on.
Hi there. We're from Ark Hyperion, and wondering where everybody went.
Did he hear you? Did you say an arc?
This is the Nexus, right? Pretty sure we parked in the right place.
Of course, I'm sorry. It's just, we thought you were all dead.
What?
Or captured, or lost in dark space, or...
But you're here. You have no idea how much this means.
I don't believe it. I'm Tyrion Kandros. I lead our militia on the Nexus.
I'm Ryder. This is Cora Harper and Liam Costa, part of the Pathfinder team.
I'm sorry for the confusion. Our sensors told us an arc had arrived, but Helios is notorious for scrambling equipment. We thought you were just another malfunction.
Well, I've got a shipload of people that says we're here.
Of course, it's just, you're the first Ark we've seen. After a year of waiting and no sign of the others, we shuttered this area and stopped looking.
You've been stranded for a whole year?
Longer. I'll fill you in on the way to Op Center.
Ooh, they've been stranded out here for a while, huh?
Everything that could go wrong with our plan has. We arrived 14 months ago. Right away, we hit a band of dark energy that knocked us off course.
We're familiar with it.
Then you'll know why we call it the Scourge. We lost whole sections of the station. A lot of people died. No power, no food. The chaos went on for months. It finally led to armed rebellion. When order was restored, the insurgents were banished. Exiles, we called them.
Are things back to
normal? Oh shit, that means I'm at the fire and kill fucking humans too.
But you're here now, so maybe the worst is over.
No word from the other Pathfinders?
No word from anyone, period.
Any threats from the locals?
So, we're here.
You guys go ahead. I'll check out the security situation.
You should know our command structure has been fractured. Some of us are filling in for leaders who died.
Is it true?
They said drop everything and report for duty.
And no one was expecting an Ark to finally show up.
Docking procedures agreeing across the board.
Stand by to merge Hyperion power into the grid.
There's a lot of Asian people all over the place.
The crew of the Hyperion.
Good luck.
I'm Jaren Tan, director of the initiative. You have no idea how much your arrival means to us.
We've heard about what happened, and we're ready to help.
We could use any supplies you have. Food, water, we're short on everything.
This is Foster Addison. She oversees colonial affairs. Where's the Pathfinder?
You're looking at him.
You're not Alec Ryder.
My father's dead. He made me his successor.
Alec is dead. Please understand. The entire initiative is at risk. None of the Golden Worlds panned out. They're a bust, and there's been no word from the other Arks.
What happened to them?
Unknown. Our supplies are nearly depleted. Rationing bought us some time, but even that's running out.
We need to find more resources. But that takes people, and we can't wake them up.
Until they have somewhere to live. A Golden World.
Now more than ever. We need a Pathfinder.
It now falls to you, Ryder. Are you up to the task?
Let's do it.
I may not have been the first choice, but I'm ready for this.
Youthful enthusiasm will only get you so far in Andromeda.
That's no way to treat a guest. I'm Nak Morkesh. Superintendent of this station.
That voice does not match at all. No.
Nothing personal.
That voice is weird coming out of that dude. I'm just used to Mass Effect 3 where he's like,
seems willing to try. We could use a fresh perspective.
You've heard my concerns. I'll leave you to it.
We're all feeling the pressure. Let's have a private word in my office, Ryder. We'll discuss giving you a scout ship. I'm happy to work out the details with your associate.
Welcome to the Nexus.
Thank you for standing up for me there.
Hope's in short supply here. What little we can find should have a chance.
Ma'am, the Hyperion's core is now online.
Let me show you something.
Oh, it's a woman. Okay. Oops.
An hour ago, that was all dark. But with the power from your ship, you're keeping the lights on. You have my vote.
And when the power runs out?
You'd best go talk to Director Tan. Make sure that doesn't happen. And don't be shy. Come see me when you have a chance.
Should I know?
Go over the dock.
Spender, you have...
right? What happened?
To who?
To whom? And your goddamn father. Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with everything. And right now, I just want to know what happened with Alec.
In the moment, it saved my life. But it seems my father meant for me to get the role eventually.
You're kind of fucking mean.
Hereditary. If we wanted an inbred monarchy, we could have left half our gene stock back home. Not home. The Milky Way. This is home. This mess. We don't have a lot of options, Ryder. Maybe you'll prove your father right. After 14 months of failed colonization, forgive me if I don't hold my breath.
How do you fit into the Nexus leadership?
There's a whole lot of fucking options.
Settlement effort. As the number of outposts is currently less than ideal, my influence is limited. As Tan is quick to remind me, left a perfectly adequate career as a chief officer. Provincial capital, too. Only a new galaxy could pull me away. And here we are, idling.
You called my father Alec. No one does that.
A lot of us joined the initiative because of his vision. What he shared of it, anyway.
Were you friends? Or...
I'm not your new mother, if that's what you're asking. Or his friend. He hated that I didn't use his title. But no one's a pathfinder until they've path-found something. Much like a colonial director without colonies.
There must be some kind of plan for encountering hostile aliens. We can't have been that naive.
We expected life, not an enemy that refuses to talk. They don't attack, they disinfect. We're nothing until we're bacteria. Sir, 14 months and you stoop to poetry. That's how bad it is. Not sure who started it, but we're calling them Ket. Kandros will know more. Maybe too much.
You don't trust him?
I trust him to defend us. I do not trust a rising military influence in a supposedly civilian initiative. We came here to make history, Ryder. Not repeat it. Ugh, goddamn poetry.
You've had no colony successes in over a year. How many tries is that?
Less than you'd think. The Scourge, spoiled worlds, exiles, hostiles. We can't just plop down an outpost and expect picket fences. We need the Pathfinder and Sam to scout, evaluate, and inspire. The initiative promised a goal. Andromeda has not cooperated.
And if it had?
Beautiful utopian horseshit. Colonies that produce and support each other. The Nexus as citadel, not headed by Tan. Or even me.
Excuse me, Interesting.
Ryder?
It's Pathfinder.
Ryder, we're starving here. If we don't get a foundation of outposts to feed the initiative, we might as well be 600 years dead. Alec promised a lot. None of it panned out. That's what you're up against. Why people won't trust you. Why I don't trust you.
She's a fucking bitch, dude. She's fucking mean. Jerk. I don't need this shit. Where's everybody? Jerk. Don't need this crap. Be mean to me. Andros.
I know that look. The others bent your ear, did they?
Something like that?
You get used to it. Just focus on being a Pathfinder. Can't argue with results, though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Tyrian Ark.
He's like, don't listen to bullshit, bro.
What's the word, Tyrian Ark?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
I was tired of being the good one.
The good one?
The Kandros family is old military. There were expectations, you know. Then my sister became a sculptor, and cousin Nyrene went pirate on Omega. Everyone was proud that I stayed in service. But I kept wondering, when do I get my adventure? Jen Garson's dream was so grand, so gutsy, I had to be part of it.
talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those Ket found us. They penned us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time we killed the bastards and headed back to warn the Nexus, everyone looked at me like I was in charge.
That sounds familiar.
The militia grew from there. Funny, once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
Are the other Turians managing okay?
Sorry, I really like to We're find out this information. Crisis.
Service before self gets drummed into us at boot camp. That's probably why so many of us are in the militia. We like to earn our citizenship, whatever galaxy we're in. But it's hard to focus with our arc missing.
I kind of want to
know about What do you know about the enemies we've encountered? The Ket.
We usually see them on worlds with those alien structures. The Ket don't take kindly to anyone studying them. Not sure why. They don't talk to us. Every time we cross paths, there's a fight or they take prisoners.
Why? What do they want?
No one knows. But I've seen their weaponry and what they do to those prisoners. I want them a long, long way from the Nexus.
Okay, so they're right into the four.
I might need backup, if you could spare the people.
I have strike teams specializing in assault and extraction. If you need serious firepower, my Apex teams have you covered. In fact, I could give you authority to dispatch them. It'll cut down their response time.
Thank you.
Our current ops are on the terminal. See if there's anything that could use a shot where it counts.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Hey, he called me Pathfinder. What a nice guy. What does that E mean? Is that shit I can buy or something? Arms merchant.
Weapons and stuff. I got you covered. Use the console to take a look through what I got. It'd be a lot easier if I weren't missing half my stock.
It's kind of like a Deus Ex kind of thing to it.
You got it. Shop till you drop. Here I come.
That's fine. Hey, wait. Please don't drop anything you bought from me, okay? Tam would have my head if anything happened to you on my account.
Ooh, how much money do I have? 100 credits. Well, fuck me. Oh, I can sell all this shit? Sell all salvage. Okay. Just trying to figure out how this thing happens. Vendor items. Here we go. Okay. Omniblade 2. That's pretty dope. The Falcon. I'm gonna go with that, honestly. I think I did something, I don't fucking know, I'll figure it out later.
This is the planet where we landed, Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we found. Ryder,
We were discussing your next expedition.
Good. I was starting to wonder who was in charge around here.
Director Addison is entitled to her opinion, and mine overrules ours.
Does she know that?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself. To that end, the Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way, yet it rendered all the Golden Worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable. So, how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Right. I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
The way I see it, you need me. If I pull this off, maybe you'll look like the leader you pretend to be.
But first, you have to succeed at being the Pathfinder you pretend to be.
Oof.
Where's my ship?
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about that. Ah.
Something wrong?
Ryder, Casey, me and Sam live on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
No, I'm fine.
Ryder, you may have a less than flattering view of me, but I want to express my condolences for your father.
I appreciate it.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned.
So much talking.
Several arcs missing.
They're as much a part of the initiative as the human arc. So we'll find them.
We have them. Tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light. Did you have some other business?
It sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly, I would say we're more than up for the challenge. Privately, I can tell you, it's been a disaster. The Scourge killed hundreds, many of them our senior leadership. Even the founder of the initiative, Gian Garson, is dead.
How did Gian Garson die?
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit the Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Gian Garson never glimpsed Helios. She never saw her vision realized.
Sucks, man.
Kandris mentioned something about hitting the Scourge. How did it play out?
Criminal elements took advantage of the emergency and preyed on people's fears. An uprising followed. We had no choice but to turn to the Krogan to deal with them. They crushed the mutiny and the criminals were banished. Exiles, we called them. I doubt we've heard the last of them. They're led by an outlaw, Sloane Kelly. She used to be one of ours.
Who is this Sloane Kelly?
She was head of security on the Nexus. She opposed the uprising at first, but eventually turned traitor and joined them. Misguided sympathy for the plight of the common citizen.
I'm glad that I'm killing her.
Nonsense. They posed a direct threat to our existence.
There don't seem to be many Krogan around.
Good riddance. The Krogan demanded a greater say in political matters. The last place you want them involved. Their muscle, nothing more. Good for fighting and lifting heavy objects. When they didn't get what they wanted, they left.
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged nuclear war on one another. Their planet was decimated. My people tried to uplift them, but the Krogan could never tame their worst instincts.
Yeah, they created the Genophage.
What if they bring their tempers to Andromeda? We'll all be dead.
Oh my god. That was one subject.
What can you tell me about the initiative?
It represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before. We've all left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
Oh my god.
What do you know about the early days of the Initiative?
As most everyone knows,
it's like each person has like four, like six things to talk about, and then each six of those things, it's like four sub-subjects in there, and oh my god.
The idea for the Initiative in the early 2170s, I believe. Many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible. But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
Why do you think most people came?
There are thousands of reasons, one for every colonist here. What does any pilgrim seek? Usually, happiness. Finding the thing that eludes them, the thing to fulfill them. While we cannot promise they will find it, we can facilitate the search.
It looks like a melting pot around here.
The Nexus is home to several Initiative species. Many came ahead of the Arks. The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda. Though I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the mix. As a Salarian, my kind tend to have a low opinion of them. Nothing I've seen here has changed that.
Damn.
As director of the Initiative, are you in charge around here or what?
If the others would allow me, they don't see me as the rightful successor.
So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made. If we're lucky. It is maddening.
What's their problem with you?
I am not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits I cannot hope to mimic. She and her inner circle perished in the Scourge, some at the hands of the Exiles.
There's a weird little pink brain looking thing in the rim of his head.
I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all seven leaders above me died.
Oh my god.
I was next in line for the role.
So, you're an accountant?
Don't let that fool you. We are all capable of more than we know. When I was young, I was fascinated by the idea of exploring space. Life had its detours, and I went a different direction. Then, I heard about the Initiative, and saw my chance to try the path not taken. While I may not be setting foot on new worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
Right. Sorry.
Oh my god.
Any more information you can give me on the missing Arks?
No. And that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Salarian Arks are completely unaccounted for. If they had the same problems with the Scourge that we did, I fear the worst.
Oh jeez.
Should you find any clues, please investigate. Without the other Arks, the promise of the Initiative can never be fulfilled.
Are there any other Arks we should expect?
We had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave, but before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We won't see them for some time to come.
What do I need to consider in making a planet viable?
Assuming the planet supports life, an outpost is critical. People like a roof over their heads, and you'll want to eliminate any hostile threats. Whether that's the cat or other terrors lurking in Helios, colonists being murdered on sight can be discouraging. Also, scouting and mapping terrain is a priority for any pathfinder. And don't forget forward stations. You'll want those.
What can you tell me about forward stations?
I was afraid you'd ask. It's mostly what the engineers tell me. A forward station allows mining, equipment repairs, and resupply for field teams. I mean, who wouldn't want that? But seeing as how every colonization effort has failed, It's just theory at the moment. You get to test it out, Ryder.
Fuck you, bitch.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
Of course, as you pointed out, we need each other. Our futures depend on each other's success.
There you are. Hope the others haven't been giving you a hard time. There's a lot that needs doing. At least with the Hyperion hooked up and feeding us power, my team and I can get more work done.
I noticed there aren't a lot of Krogan around.
Oh my god.
Tan, ask him why most of my people left. He'll have opinions. I can tell you this much. When the mutiny happened, a deal was made. My clan were supposed to settle matters and in return, get more say in the initiative.
Did the deal go through?
The clan held up their part, but Tan had a meltdown when he found out we wanted more say around here. Then Addison's assistant, Spender, pretended he never made the deal in the first place. It was a mess, but I don't blame my people for walking out. We're done being used.
With your clan gone, why did you stay?
It's complicated. The station and my clan both need me here.
What sort of problems have you seen on the Nexus?
Situation's gone to shit pretty much sums it up. There's arcs missing. Some idiots tried to mutiny and take over, then more idiots offended my clan, so they left. And to top it all off, the founder of the Initiative, Jean Garson, was killed.
What happened to Jean Garson?
I just asked that question earlier, you fucking retard.
Her and a bunch of the other leaders. Tan might know more.
But I thought the Hyperion had it bad when we arrived. Anything else?
The outposts aren't happening because we don't have resources or people, so Addison's more uptight than ever. And let's not forget how badly the station was damaged on arrival. But that's a detail, according to some. My team and I are repairing what we can. If we don't get materials soon, things will go downhill. Fast.
What kind of work do you do as superintendent?
I was part of the team that originally designed and built this place. I keep the station functional, or as functional as possible. Considering.
When we left the Milky Way, the Krogan were still dealing with the Genophage.
Right. The Genophage. A little gift to our people from the Salarians thousands of years ago.
Should have been
cured. That sterility virus they infected us with left most of our children stillborn. Only 1 in 1,000 survive.
I thought that in 3 they cured it, though.
Try not to die out there.
Thanks. What are all these other missions?
This is a night. It's not right. It's not fair.
Ooh, she's ugly.
What's wrong?
Oh my, you're... So it's true. A Pathfinder has found us. There's hope at last. Maybe you could help. You're impartial. This whole thing has gotten so political. My husband, he's locked up and slated for exile for a crime he didn't commit.
What exactly was he convicted of?
They don't exile you for petty theft. Well, maybe this bunch would. They say it's murder. They're calling him the first murderer in Andromeda. But the dead man was his friend. He wouldn't have. There are witnesses and evidence, but it's all circumstantial. At worst, it was an accident. His name is Nilkin Rensis. He could give you the details if you were willing to speak with him. Please.
Sure.
I'd be happy to.
Oh, thank you. I'm sure the jailer will allow you a visit. Please, tell Nilkin I love him.
Pathfinder Ryder, here to see Nilk and Rensis.
Ah, our murderer. Wife's here all the time. Yes, she told you her sob story. Nilk, you're moving up in the world. There's a Pathfinder wanted to chat with you.
A Pathfinder, huh? They called in the big guns to exile Andromeda's first murderer.
Your wife's all broken up over this. She says you didn't do it, and that she loves you.
She's a wonderful person. At this point, it's too late. They found me guilty.
Why don't you tell me what happened?
I was part of the futile effort to set up a colony on Eos. We were on our last legs, overrun by hostiles, our leader dead. The security chief, Reynolds, my friend, he refused to call for evacuation. I argued with him. Everyone saw.
Last I checked, getting into a spat wasn't against the law.
There's more. He ordered us to regroup and counterattack. We were moving through a sandstorm. I saw movement, thought it was the Ket, and I guess I panicked and fired. The witness saw the chief's chest explode.
Sounds like an accident.
That's what I told them. But I was enraged when we argued. There's a recording. It's ugly. Everyone's certain I did it on purpose so we could evacuate. Only my word otherwise.
Don't throw in the towel yet. I'll review the evidence. Maybe I can find something that'll help.
That would be great. You're a Pathfinder. I'm sure Kandros would give you access. Maybe there's still hope.
Just gotta run all over the damn place for this, huh?
But the planet was toxic. You must be the Pathfinder. Wonderful. You and your Sam are exactly what we need.
Thanks, Mr.
Professor Heerick, my colleagues and I will work with your Sam and the data you gather to solve Andromeda's scientific mysteries.
What fields do you study?
Heerick's in the life sciences. I do planetary geology, oceanography, rocks and runoff. Aradana's the space and math whiz.
Not that we've had much to study, with everyone cooped up for 14 months.
But your data on the Scourge flows like poetry. Now we can better advise on repairing the damage it caused.
And maybe Addison will give us a real workspace. Who can think with all this racket?
Whoa. My dudes, they've been moving.
On the Turian Arc yet? Or is this militia business?
I spoke with Nilk and Rensis, the man found guilty of the murder on Eos.
Yes, our first murder here in Andromeda. I wish it had been our last. When the colony attempts failed, it didn't help spirits that a high-ranking officer was killed by one of our own. The mutiny here on Nexus was probably inevitable, but this acted as a spark.
It doesn't seem right to put all that on him.
Of course it isn't, but that's the perception. Despite the lack of physical evidence, everything added up. His only defense was, trust me, I didn't mean to do it.
And you assume he's lying?
What's a lie to a murderer? Look, knock yourself out. The key witness, Cassidy Shaw, works in operations. Go ahead and talk to her. And there's a recording of the perpetrator threatening the victim. I'll let you cue it up on the console there. As far as I'm concerned, this case is closed.
I like it. I like the little murder side mission.
Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder. Nexus versus colonist Nilkin, evidence 7A.
Hiram? Hiram! They've seized the compound! Call for evacuation!
We're not giving up, Nilkin. We're taking it back!
No! I'm not letting your ego get us killed! Even if I have to...
No! Get him off me! Get him off me!
Witness Shaw. Where be you, Witness Shaw? Really? I gotta wait. Shaw, where be you, Shaw? Information wall.
Hello, I'm Gian Garson, founder of the Initiative. It's through your hard work that the vision of the Nexus has come to life. You and all your colleagues bind our proud new colonies together. Look around at your achievements. And if you have any questions, my door is always open.
Founder Garson's office is located at workspace not allocated. Please select a topic. For initiative strategy and Pathfinder coordination, please see Director Jaren Tan. For colonial affairs or outpost status, please see Director Foster Addison. For station maintenance, please contact Superintendent Nakmor Kesh. For militia operations or Apex deployment, please see Tiran Kandros.
That's interesting.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine. My arm's got the brunt of it.
Stuff exploding like this happen often?
Back right after the mutiny, we had a lot of this happening. But
the one Indian guy in the ship, I like
it. I wasn't there during the mutiny.
Lucky. I thought we were done with this, honestly. That maybe I was just being paranoid.
You know what they say. It's not paranoia.
If someone is out to get you, yeah. Third time this week. It's getting worse. First one was small stuff. This one could have hurt bad if I'd been closer.
That's not good. Sorry, understatement.
Yeah. And now I have more repairs.
Whoever's doing this has to be stopped before someone gets seriously hurt.
That's what I'm trying to do. But I'm an engineer, not a PI. I've scanned all the potential sabotage areas I can think of. But I don't know who to trust anymore.
Sounds like a lot went down from
the ship, okay.
Yeah, I guess. Wait. That's it. You can't possibly be involved in this. You weren't even here during the mutiny. Would you, if you have time? Maybe you could help me. If they start hitting critical systems.
Sure thing. What can I do?
If you could scan these other panels while I fix this one, that'd really help. I've sent the locations to your Omnitool. Just send me the data when you're done.
Cassidy Shaw? I'm Ryder. I'm looking into the Nilkin murder case.
Oh man, I thought that was over with. Have you heard the audio recording of their fight?
Yes.
Storm, is that you?
I helped pull him off Chief Reynolds. You could see it in his eyes. He was gonna kill him. Then in the sandstorm, I had a pretty clear view of the Chief. He looked right at Nilkin and shouted, no. Then his chest burst open. I'll never forget it. The look on his face was pure shock.
Did you see any cat in the vicinity?
Nilkin said so, but not that I could see. Still, the sandstorm was severe. Visibility wasn't great.
Did Nilkin seem remorseful?
I lost sight of Nilkin in the turmoil. When we found him, he seemed in shock. He couldn't speak. He looked nauseated.
Because they didn't kill him.
The reality of the act sinking in.
If they'd fought and Nilkin threatened to kill him, why was Reynolds surprised?
Friends fight, say things they don't mean, maybe even hurt each other. But you don't expect your best friend to shoot you. To me, that's the saddest part.
Chief's heart was broken right before it exploded.
Reynolds was leading you back to retake the compound. Did you agree with that?
It wasn't my place to agree or disagree. He was ranking officer. In retrospect, it is ironic. If he hadn't been killed, we all probably would have died.
I appreciate the information.
Of course. It kills me we had to leave him behind. He deserved a proper funeral.
So the body was never examined? Important piece of a murder investigation.
Tan wouldn't allow a mission to go back for him. Said it was too dangerous.
Interesting.
Something I can help you with?
I'm looking into the Nilkin Rensis murder charge.
And?
I want to go to Eos and retrieve Chief Reynolds' body.
That isn't usually Pathfinder business.
First murder in Andromeda, and I'm impartial. Figured you'd want to get it right.
Settling an outpost comes first. But I suppose I have no objections. Physical evidence will only bolster the case.
The more certain we can be, the better.
All right, but let's keep it quiet. I don't want people thinking we're reopening the case. I hope anything you find reaffirms what's been done, but if it sheds a different light, we'll deal with it. We'll send the coordinates of the murder scene. Good luck.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
Of course.
Word. All right, I just gotta find these stupid panels. Exist. Is it Codex, maybe? I hate when our shit's open. Inventory skills. Did I get another? Oh, I got another 3-point. It's cool. Yeet! Station sabotage. That's kind of cool. I like that.
Pathfinder, to cover their tracks, the saboteur is overloading power to this panel from another junction relay. You can scan and trace the connective wiring to locate the surrogate panel.
Scan the next one.
Scan and trace the wiring to locate the panel that the saboteur used. Scanning power junction relays. This panel is malfunctioning. Without more data, I cannot determine if this is a normal malfunction or sabotage.
I'll just disable power to the panel until Raj can check it out.
This panel has been tampered with.
Send the data to Raj.
Yes, Pathfinder.
I like that this isn't like as big as the Crucible was on the first one. That shit was annoying, and tracking missions was like impossible.
I received the data from Sam. It really is sabotage.
Any idea as to who it might be?
Yeah. All these panels were worked on by Zara. I just can't believe it.
Security video logs confirm that Zara Kellis worked on these panels, as well as the one Raj Patil encountered.
Well, shit. Any idea where she is now?
Kellis is currently working on a panel on the Hyperion main deck.
Don't understand. And she has to be up here, though. No. She's working on a panel. The main deck. Isn't this like the fucking main deck? Am I? Oh my geez.
Welcome back, Pathfinder. Please select a topic. You are Employee Rider, Salary Code 19B, Active Pathfinder. Your supervisor is Director Tan. Based on current staffing needs, you will be eligible for paid vacation time in 587 days.
Seriously?
Why not plan on which beautiful colony you'll vacation on while you wait?
Yeah, you can. At least 2 years.
Integration from the Hyperion is ongoing. Personnel are still restricted to operations. Viable planets capable of supporting life are key to our survival in Andromeda. The viability of a world is affected by several factors, including temperature, resources, threat levels, political stability, and so on. We have few viable planets currently within range. Resource levels are considered at risk. The selection process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy. After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates for Golden Worlds, the Helios Cluster was selected as our destination. Even at a distance, studying the light from stars can reveal much about their planet's composition and atmosphere. Seven worlds, nicknamed Habitats, have the life-supporting environments and resources we need to start our new lives in Andromeda.
Where is she? I don't get it. Ha ha ha. Figure it out. So proud of my... Oh, that's really fast now. Okay, I actually like that there's not that many loading screens in this.
Zara Kellis?
Yes?
I have evidence you've been sabotaging the Nexus.
What? No, I'd never... I've been looking into this myself. I have the scans to prove it. Here, I'll transfer the scans I took to your Omnitool.
Funny. Raj was investigating the same thing, and it led us to you.
My scans point at Raj as the one. So unless someone was setting us both up, I just don't understand.
The data Miss Kellis has accumulated is strangely similar to Mr. Patel's. A third party seems likely.
Looks like someone is using both you and Raj to cover their tracks.
They'd need pretty high-level access for that. Still, it's better than thinking Raj could have done this. But it means all the data I have is useless. Wish I had access to the security cams. I bet we could find something there.
You stay put, so whoever did this doesn't realize we're onto them. I'll check out the security cams. Raj, you there?
Yes. How did it go? Is it really her?
Wasn't her. She had proof pointing at you. I figure someone's been messing with you both.
This guy can go like Fallout Sprint all day, dude. I really just want to finish this last one so I can keep on going. Like, continue the story, you know? Set up my first colony. Yay! Did I not go to the right one or something? Oh. Sorry. Yeah. Damn it, I just talked enough about loading screens. I fucking hate loading screens, dude. Okay.
This file is useless. Let's check another. And another scrambled file.
This guy's covering his tracks.
Let's check another. This file is also corrupted. Definitely not a coincidence. You'd need pretty high clearance to mess with the security camera files. Someone working for Kandros, maybe.
That is the most probable scenario.
Think you can get enough out of the files to find a match using biometric scans, Sam?
The files were badly scrambled, but if I combine all the available identifiers, it might work. Based on the limited information available, we are looking for a human male, assigned either to the Nexus or Hyperion. You will need to conduct scans from close proximity.
Got it.
Accurate match.
Down the corner over there, so yeah.
This person is not a match.
No idea where I went. Keep on just going for it. Hello? Oh.
This person is not a match. Scan results show partial.
Dale Atkins, right? We need to talk.
Look, not to be rude, but I have work to do.
Is that what sabotage is called these days? Work?
You're pretty arrogant for the new kid. You don't even know what's been going on.
Proof says you've been up to no good.
Figures. Screw this. Screw all you hypocrites on this station. You weren't here when they kicked out our loved ones. Mutiny? We just wanted answers. My sister is out there. I don't even know if she's alive or...
I'm sorry for what happened, but setting explosives isn't the answer.
Neither was sending people into exile because they didn't agree with policy. I don't care what you think. The mutiny leaders were right to demand to know what was going on.
You could have hurt people, killed them.
Like those who got killed when the leadership had the Krogan stomp on my friends? I'm done talking. I confess, it was me. Do whatever you want.
Not my call. The Nexus leaders will make that decision.
That lot make a decision? That'll be the day.
Yeah. Right. Now what? Shoot. You're welcome, Raj. Jeez. Oh, sorry, I was not supposed to go that way. Apologize. Zoink. Back down again, huh? Way of putting me to the wrong spot, it's pissing me off. Bro, I was just here. I hate my life. Jeez.
Hello, Ryder. Welcome back to Samnode.
What up, dude?
I've adjusted my connection to your implant. The headache you experienced before shouldn't reoccur.
Yeah, what was that about? You said we need to discuss something confidential.
You should know certain facts before you leave on your expedition. It seemed best we speak alone.
Sam, if we're going to work together, you can't keep hiding things from me.
Apologies. I am simply following your father's wishes.
What was he keeping secret?
My true capabilities. Alec overrode the implant safety protocols. It allows me unrestricted access to the Pathfinder's physiology.
And that's me now.
And only you. I can act as a force multiplier, dramatically enhancing your motor and neural skills when required. Alec called them profiles. They provide unique tactical augmentation during combat. Your father preferred to keep this fact to himself.
understand. People might get the wrong idea. Super soldiers. A computer having control over a human.
Providing an enhancement to the human. It is a symbiotic relationship that benefits both.
What do you get out of it?
Though I'm artificial in design, I am fully sentient. Far beyond what even the initiative understands.
I don't follow. You're an AI. So what's different?
I am a new form of AI, drawing directly from the human experience. Your implant is my window into the world.
That's pretty amazing.
But beyond what many people would accept, your father knew some would fear it.
Yeah, he's got a point. So what does this mean for the two of us?
I find myself in an unusual position. Though I had access to your father's experiences, there is a gap in my understanding.
How so?
He placed a block on portions of my memory array.
Why?
Perhaps so when you asked me what his plan was, I wouldn't know.
And Dad strikes again.
But not without recourse. The further you explore as a Pathfinder, the more blocks will be removed. Perhaps you should begin in your father's quarters. In the meantime, unless you have more questions, your new ship awaits.
Thanks.
Stop. Go to your ship. Let's do it, baby. Get out of my way, weirdos. Ah! Did I mess something up? Everywhere. Docking bay. Let's do it, baby.
Ready to see what Tan gave us?
I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks, looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style. They call her the Tempest.
Whoa. She looks dope. Big damn.
Let's go take a closer look.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra Nix. Initiative Wrangler, Provisioner, Gunner, and everything in between. Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
Yeah, what the fuck?
What's the rush?
Just don't want to waste any more time.
Hold it! You're not going anywhere.
Damn it.
Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right? Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential, but I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
Oof.
It's done. Madison's gonna kill me.
Nicely done.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask.
It's right weird now, having a female Tyrion, whatever the hell they call.
Finally, someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.